Good morning, children. Earlier in this chapter, we have studied two laws. The first law was Boyle's law. Boyle's law said that volume is inversely proportional to pressure when the temperature is constant. In this, volume and pressure relationship is being shown, which is an inverse relationship, temperature remaining constant. Now, the second law was Charles' law, which mentioned that volume is directly proportional to absolute temperature when the pressure remains constant. Now, in both these laws, we are seeing the volumes when one of the parameter, either the temperature, which is in Boyle's law, is constant, or the pressure in the Charles' law is constant. One of the parameters is constant and another is changing. In Boyle's law, volume and pressure are shown in relationship, temperature remaining constant. And in Charles' law, volume and temperature relationship is being shown, pressure remaining constant. Now suppose if you have some condition in which both the parameters, temperature and pressure, are simultaneously changing. Nothing is constant. You have to find the volume when temperature and pressure both are changing. In such a case, what you will be doing is, you will be combining both these laws, Boyle's law and Charles' law. A combination of these two gas laws will be used. And that combined equation, which is used for finding volume when both temperature and pressure are simultaneously changing, is known as gas equation. So now we are going to see if we have to find out the volume of a gas if temperature and pressure both are changing simultaneously. So we are going to combine these two laws. On combining these two laws, what we will be get, we will see that according to your Boyle's law, what is happening? Volume is inversely proportional to pressure, so V is inversely proportional to P, and V is, according to Charles' law, V is directly proportional to temperature, so this will become as V is inversely proportional to pressure and directly proportional to temperature. Like this, we are going to combine it. So finally, it will be coming as, we'll remove this proportionality sign and we'll put a constant K. So it will be coming as V is equal to K into 1 upon P into T. That means V is equal to K into T upon P. Or you can write it as V into P upon T is equal to K, which is your constant. K is constant. So now this equation, V into P upon T is equal to constant, is known as gas equation. This equation we will be using when we have some calculation in which we have to calculate the volume when both the pressure as well as temperature are changing. Fine. Suppose, so we have seen that our gas equation is what? V into P upon T, which is equal to constant. Now let us take an example. We have a gas X. We have suppose its volume is V1, pressure is P1, and temperature is T1 under certain conditions. And on changing the condition, the final volume is, final volume is V2, a pressure is P2 and temperature is T2. So you have initial volume, pressure and temperature as V1, P1 and T1, and final volume, pressure and temperature as V2, P2 and T2. So you can write this as fitting it into the gas equation, you can write it as V1 into P1 upon T1 is equal to V2 into P2 upon T2, which will be equals to constant K. So this equation we will be using in our numericals, which we are going to do further.